biggest band in the world, One Direction!
Let's go crazy, crazy, crazy till we see the sun.
6 years ago, Louis Tomlinson and his mates broke our hearts with the news that some of us knew all along.
I think eventually they're just all going to go and eventually they're going to become One Direction. There's going to be nobody left.
Louis said hooroo to the boy band life and embarked on a beautiful new solo adventure.
You kill my mind.
His debut album, Walls, revealed a more soulful side to the singer, fusing Louis' love of Britpop with darker themes. The record collected more than 3 billion streams before Louis announced he was bringing it down under for his first headline tour. Then the pandemic happened.
Yeah.
But he came back to us, landing on our shores this week to play a bunch of sold-out shows. Who's happy about it?
Louis Tomlinson, welcome to the project.
Hello, hello, thanks for having me.
Great to have you here. I mean, it's been a long time in the making. 2 years, I think, since this tour was meant to happen. You played your first gig in Brizzy last night. How did it go?
It was amazing. The crowd were unbelievable. I think it's about 7 years since I've been in Australia. Absolutely
wow.
Love this country. And the crowd was amazing.
And this is your first tour without the old band, of course. Are you loving the freedom that comes with being a solo artist?
Yeah, it's exciting, but it's also challenging, you know, being part of a group. You can only put so much of yourself into that. So I suppose this tour has just been, it's already taught me quite a lot, to be fair. I've had to kind of take on my own independence musically and creatively, but it's definitely been fun.
I feel like you've all done that, actually. Solo stuff sounds quite different to the stuff you're doing together. I imagine it's very different writing a song when Simon Cowell isn't breathing down your neck and ticking things off. Is there some kind of feeling that you're finally doing the music you'd always wanted to do?
For myself, yeah, for myself, definitely. But I think, you know, when you look at the One Direction stuff, that's stuff that I'm obviously immensely proud of and, you know, was kind of amazing for what it was. But obviously now going out doing my own stuff, for me it's just been about trying to create the record that I want to create, but also, you know, not alienating the fans and kind of meeting in the middle of those two ideas, really.
Well, your fans are very passionate and they do occasionally like to throw gifts at you on stage. You've had plenty of things hurled up there over your career. What is the weirdest thing that has either ever landed in front of you or hit you?
That's a good question, to be fair. Someone threw a burger up the other day, which is kind of random. I threw it back, to be fair.
Was it still in the wrapper?
It was still in the wrapper, to be fair. Yeah,
right.
Untouched. Yeah, but I didn't eat it.
You said it was 7 years since you've been here last time. What are you wanting to do down under? Is there stuff you didn't get to do last time or that you loved doing last time that you can't wait to do again?
Not anything too specific, really. I just love this country. I love being here. I've done a lot of travelling this year and, you know, seen a lot of different places. But Australia feels close to home, definitely. So it's just a shame that we've come in winter and the weather's shit.
Well, have you seen the weather in the UK? Might not be much better right now.
Yeah, man. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's crazy. It's crazy.
Hey, Louis, there's been a bit of 1D beef recently, thanks to Liam, who's been speaking out about the band a little bit. When you look back on your experience with the band, how do you feel about those days?
Oh, so the fishing's begun already. yeah, I see what you're doing. No, listen, I'm immensely proud, as I know Liam is. I'm immensely proud of those days, obviously. I mean, you know, it was an incredible thing to do, and especially at such a young age. But amazing memories, man, amazing memories.
Louis, when you say, oh, the fishing's begun, I imagine it is so annoying having to answer retrospective questions like that. I'm genuinely interested. How much do you want to talk about that time in your life to the media versus how much you never want to have to talk about it ever again?
No, good question. I mean, I'm more than happy to talk about it in every interview. You know, that's something I'm immensely proud of, as I'd already said. It's just when you mentioned the beef before, it sounded like you were getting ready to stir some shit up. That's all I'm saying.
No, I'm not a shit stirrer, Louis. Do I look like a shit stirrer?
These guys definitely aren't stirrers, Louis. But I am. And I've spotted something overnight that I imagine will make you incensed. It turns out that a Texas university announced overnight that it's launching a new course on Harry Styles called Harry Styles and the Cult of Celebrity. That should be you, shouldn't it?
Yeah, I don't really have any interest in having a course made about me, to be fair.
I mean, it's a very strange thing not to be interested in.
You sound very interested, to be fair. Maybe you should sign up.
He's done every degree you can imagine. Just, you can add that to your list, Louis.
Just quietly, Louis, I may have designed that course.
Walls, your debut album dropped over 2 years ago now. When can we expect a follow-up?
Come on, Louis.
No pressure.
No pressure.
Soon. Very soon. I'm pretty much done with the record. I feel really excited about it, but soon. That's all I'm going to say.
And what's it called, Louis?
Not telling you.
Okay, just give us.
You'll have to wait and see.
Just give us the track listing then.
You're not having none of that.
So there's just a few tickets left for Louis' Aussie shows. So grab your burgers, head to our website, get ready to go to the show. Louis, it's an absolute pleasure having you in the country. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me. Cheers. Nice chat to you.
Amazed at the decisions that fans make in a crowd of what they want to throw up, but a burger, truly, what are you thinking?
I've never heard
of
that.
Why would you waste it?
Is Louis falling in love with you because you threw up a burger? How is that, like your undies, maybe? But a burger?
Maybe. Are you responding to undies being thrown at you?
I don't know, but at least that says, like, I'm hot for you. What does a burger say?
It says, let's have
dinner. I'm hungry for you.